Hey, who was the first person who ever said anything to you about Jesus? Maybe a parent, a relation, a friend, a teammate at sport, a coach? The first time I really heard anything about Jesus was when I was chosen for my school cricket team. Now, I was only chosen because a boy got sick just before the team left for a game, and it was very easy for me to get my cricket equipment and jump on the team bus to go. So that's why I was chosen. But it meant I was 3 years younger than all the other boys. And very kindly, the captain sat by me on a long journey to the game. So it was very kind of him. We went and played the game. We won the game. I didn't do anything to contribute. I just made up the numbers. And on the way back, he sat next to me again. Just kind, you know, to a younger boy. He says to me, it was a Monday. What did you do at the weekend, Graham? I said, well, I played cricket Saturday, of course. But it was a long time ago. It was the 20th century. And nobody did anything on Sunday in 1970 something because all the shops were closed and everybody went to church in my country. Well, everybody over 40 anyway. I didn't go to church. And I said, I played cricket Saturday and Sunday I did nothing. It was boring. I said, what about you? Now, this guy's cool, right? He's cool. He's a really good athlete. He's 3 years older than me. He's nearly got a beard. I look up to him. He said, oh, I played cricket Saturday and I went to church Sunday. I couldn't believe it. I looked at him. I said, you went to church? Do your parents still make you go to church? In other words, and do you go? And he looked at me and he said, oh, no, I go to church because I follow Jesus. Oh my goodness, I couldn't believe it. This guy is cool. And of course, I'm a sporty kid, right? And I love sport, and he's a really good player. I didn't know anyone could be a Christian who was a real sports person. That was a tipping point for me. And if our theme is how do you make followers of Jesus in the world of sport, that story may give you a feel of what happens. Somebody who loves sport and is decent at sport, shares something about Christianity and lives it out with another person who's stuck into sport. That's how followers of Jesus are made in sport. Let's dig this out a little bit and have a look at it. Let's take a few lines from Jesus' mouth at the end of one of the four accounts of his life, the account by a man called Matthew, and the end of the last chapter, the 28th chapter. It's the last conversation Jesus has with his 11 remaining disciples before he leaves this world to return to heaven. And it's the conversation where he gives them the final instructions for what to do when he's gone. So it's for us. Let me read the lines to you. All authority in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Therefore, go and make disciples, followers, of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, and teaching them to obey everything I have commanded you. And surely, I am with you always to the very end of the age. Let's have a look at that couple of lines there from two perspectives. Let's look at them again and see what Jesus's role is in making followers and what our role is. Let's have a look at them. Jesus' role. Simple, really. He says, I'm in charge of the whole thing. Here's the line, verse 18 of chapter 28 from Matthew. All authority in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Not some authority, not lots of authority, all authority. Not in some places in heaven, but not earth. Heaven and earth given to Jesus. This is the most important thing in making followers of Jesus. Remember this. He's in charge. He's in charge of it all. He was in charge that day when I was on that bus to that game. He is ultimately the one who helps men and women, boys and girls, understand that they can know Jesus personally. He's got it. He's got control of it. That's so comforting when you know you're not the primary agent in this. But here's a second part. We do have a part to play. Let's see verse 19 again, because there is a role for us in helping people become followers of Jesus. Therefore, go and make disciples of all nations, Jesus says to them, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, and teaching them to obey everything I have commanded you. Let's take some of those words. Make disciples, he says to them. You go make followers. You have a part to play, in other words. Off you go. Okay. Where are they to make followers? That's the next word. In all nations. Now, when we think of nations, we think of countries, states. I come from Wales, clearly one of the finest nations on earth. But nations doesn't mean that in the context of the New Testament era. It comes from a word ethne or ethnic. It denotes something more close to language groups, people groups, tribes. So that's what we should think of when we think nations. And now, do you see? Sport is a nation. Sports are nations. People groups who play different sports are nations. Jesus says, if you're a Christian, go and help people to become followers of mine in your nation of sport, where you coach or play. That's your nation. You represent Jesus there. He put you there. He gave you the talents to be there. Go on, off you go. So Jesus is in charge. Our role is to make followers in sport. How do we do it? Jesus says in these lines, three things happen and we do them. Number one, we go. We don't wait. We don't say, come to me. We get stuck into the ethne, the ethnic, the nation, the people of sport. Get in amongst it. Play, train, enjoy it. You're talented for it. Make the most of it. Go there. Secondly, he says, baptize them in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. In other words, go and make followers of mine in every people group. And if somebody does want to be a follower of Jesus, the New Testament symbol of that is baptism. So what he's saying here is, when you go, if people, like I listen to my friend, if people do think they'd like to be a Christian, formalize that. That's what a baptism is. In the name of God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Here's the great message here. Be expectant. Expect that if you are stuck into the ethne, the nation of sport, and if you stand for Christ, there will be people who Jesus draws to himself. And they will become a follower of Jesus as you have become. It's pretty fundamental and straightforward, actually. And third, he says, make disciples, baptizing and teaching them to obey everything I have commanded you. Again, very straightforward. If a person becomes a follower of Jesus, they tell people that they are a follower of Jesus, but there's always a need to go on being taught from the Bible, from God's word, how to live out your life as a Christian in our context, in the world or nation of sport. So God's role, Jesus' role, our role, but we can't finish without returning to Jesus' role, because he knows we sometimes get a bit scared. Or we sometimes think, I'm not very good at making followers of Jesus. So he reminds us in the very last line of this account of his life and the very last sentence he tells his followers about making disciples. He reminds them he's in charge. Look at that wonderful line. And surely I am with you always to the very end of the age. Don't you love that line? If you think, well, how do I do this? Surely other people should do this. Well, surely, he says, be in no doubt. I am with you, present tense, always. Not sometimes. I'll always be there on the bus to the game. And I won't be there for a while. I'll be there till the very end of the age, which is his way of saying, until I'm back. I'm coming back. Ah, thanks. Thanks, Jesus. How do I make followers of yours? He's just explained it to us. Pretty straightforward, isn't it? I said at the beginning, who first told you about Jesus? And I give you my answer, right? A really good guy, good athlete in the world of sport who passed on the Christian message to me by the way he spoke and by the way he lived. Here's the great question now. And who knows the results of you acting on this question? Who will you tell?